In recent years, some of the most intriguing and surprising discoveries in the space sciences have been provided by comets. Several space missions have allowed opportunities to test the predictions of standard comet theory versus those of the electric universe. More than ever, it's clear that a new picture of comets is required for institutional science. At the forthcoming Thunderbolts Conference, Elegant Simplicity, taking place June 17th to 19th in Phoenix, Arizona, physicist Eugene Bagashov will present a new analysis of cometary orbits that may provide further support to the electric comet hypothesis.
I believe that the electric comet idea is one of the most intriguing areas of the electric universe field. First of all, because it concerns the bodies we might readily interact with on a reasonable timescale, even with our limited resources, as opposed to, for example, more distant astrophysical objects and objects of much bigger scale, such as galaxies, for example, which we cannot probe just as easily and thoroughly. And cometary processes are taking place right now, as opposed to the proposed large-scale electric events of the past, where the scope of evidence is limited due to obvious reasons. Here, on the contrary, we have a growing field of evidence and ever-increasing quality of data. This provides a good basis for an increasingly intense scientific examination and research regarding the electric comet idea. In the recent couple of years, at least one important step in this direction was taken by Franklin Anariba with his examination of possible electrochemical aspects of cometary phenomena. I personally think his presentation at the EU 2015 Paths of Discovery Conference was among the best. I'm highly anticipating to hear his talk at the EU 2016 Conference coming in June. I also believe that Subhan Ibadov, a professor from Moscow State University, is going to give his talk at this year's conference on related phenomena concerning possible discharges in the cometary environment. I consider all of those topics being highly relevant and interesting, but what I was interested in since about a year ago is a more macroscopic, or maybe statistical approach, so to speak, that is dealing with the whole population of comets rather than some individual comet, and considering the probability of some abstract probe body with given orbital parameters to be a comet, to discharge like a comet under the electric comet idea. So I've started doing my own research in this field, trying to play with the statement that the cometary behavior is caused by the high eccentricities of cometary orbits, causing the comets to significantly change the radial distance to the Sun along their orbits, thus moving through changing electromagnetic environments and discharging in the solar wind. So I basically wanted to look at the data and try to find any correlations between eccentricities and the number of comets or the percentage of comets out of all the small bodies, because the absolute majority of the small bodies are asteroids, of course. Theoretically, if we'd find a direct increase of the percentage of comets with increasing eccentricity, that would pose a significant and strong support to the electric comet idea. And indeed, I found a significant increase of the percentage of comets with rising eccentricity. But this dependence, the graph that I've produced, is quite nonlinear and shows some interesting features. It is changing its overall shape in certain intervals of eccentricity parameter. My first thought was that this looks like changing regimes of discharge, pretty much like in a laboratory plasma tube. Though it seems not so simple, and I've yet struggled to find a decent and more or less viable explanation. Maybe some feedback from electrical engineers and other people from the EU community would provide some insight. In general, what I'd like to say is that my talk is going to be more of an invitation to sharing thoughts and ideas and making some introductory steps rather than a presentation of some well-developed theory. It is still more a question than an answer, but this question could not have been posed without the initial electric comet idea. And as it is said, the right question is already half the answer.